On Friday, police confirmed that 9 people, including 2 children from the same family, were killed in a tragic accident along Masaka Highway. In a statement released by traffic police, the accident involved a Toyota Alphard vehicle, registration number UBL314C, and a fuel truck, registration number SSD327S/SSD137Q, and it occurred at around 4 p.m. at Choja Trading Center in Chinoni along the Masakambara Highway. Chris Ntege, Cinderella Butesi, and 2 of their children, Jaden Alvin Sibambi and Gianna Florence Ntege, were involved in the fatal accident. Today, 3 funeral vehicles delivered the bodies of the fallen family members to Gwafu in Seta town amid weeping from the family members. The caskets containing the bodies of the deceased arrived at exactly 1 p.m. and it was a somber mood as they were being taken into the main house by those in charge of the burial event, as the mourners looked on in grief. One of the family members, Aliyah Lukoya, has explained the agony they have gone through ever since the tragedy happened. She also refuted claims by bloggers that the deceased were drunk while driving. This is a tragedy indeed. You've all seen the bodies arrive. There have been reports that the deceased were drunk at the moment. This is not true. We ask government to work on the road because it's too deadly. Masaka Road has a lot of black spots. This is not the first time such an incident is happening on the same road. Leaders in Mukono District, who included the chairman LC3 of Mukono Central Division, Robert Peter Kabanda, and Councillor Moses Bukenya, have asked government to mark black spots along different roads in a bid to curb road carnage.
First, a tragedy of our people perishing in an accident on Mbarara Masaka Road, which black spot has been spotted and talked about by even the residents for many times, but the government has stayed adamant on such black spots. Our humble appeal to the government is that they would streamline those black spots on Masaka Mbarara Highway to save the lives, but also to equip our hospitals with medication and medicine to try and save lives of our people.
There will be a Requiem Mass at St. James Church in Gwafu tomorrow in the morning, which will be presided over by the Bishop of Mukono, Right Reverend Enos Chitokagodo. And later, the deceased will be buried at Namaiba in Nachisunga sub-county in Mukono District. Report compiled by Joanita Nakate for the news.